This is the SAP Developer News for December 18th, 2025.
Tomorrow, Joule Studio is expected to release the much-anticipated Agent Builder, where you can create agents for yourself without coding in order to extend Joule. You provide the instructions and the context, as well as a set of skills and other tools, and the agent will analyze, plan, and execute the appropriate actions all by itself. You can specify the LLM you want to use, how much thinking you want the agent to do, as well as several more settings. Included are several features even the beta participants did not get to see, including vibe coding, where you can use prompts to build your agent step by step. You can connect to an MCP server and bring those skills into your agent. And you can create sub-agents that can be called by your main agent. Maria Kontratyeva, a senior product manager who's been working tirelessly to get this release out the door before Christmas, says that you will incur no additional unit cost through the end of January when you deploy and test your new agents. I will leave a set of links to materials about Joule Studio and the Agent Builder, including documentation, webinars, and Maria's recent appearance on the very popular Unlocking SAP BTP podcast. That's a really nice jingle. All the links are in the description. Now that Joule Studio is complete with the Agent Builder and the Skill Builder, I assume now more than ever you'll want to install Joule Studio and get started. Lucky for you, product management, specifically Maria and Charon, have produced two blogs on how to set up Joule Studio, one specifically for partners and one specifically for customers. It will show you the SKUs you need for build and Joule. It'll show you the boosters, the formations, the security setup, the roles, and everything that you need for whatever landscape you're using, and whether or not you've already installed Joule Studio or Joule or Process Automation. Links to both of those blogs are also in the description.
Christmas is around the corner, and the SAP ABAP team brings you ABAP Holiday Calendar 2025. Check out the LinkedIn post by Sonia, where she highlights the key achievements in the area of ABAP in this year.
I have some really cool news for all the SAP AI developers out there. It's basically an early Christmas gift because my friend from development just reached out to me and they told me that Generative AI Hub is now an official large language model provider for LiteLLM. Now, what is LiteLLM? LiteLLM is an open source library that basically unifies all the different API calls to the different large language model providers. So if it's compatible now with Generative AI Hub, that means that you can use all the models that we partner with. You can use Generative AI Hub and LiteLLM, and then all the cool agent development kits, for example, that are compatible with LiteLLM. And that is really cool because the list is endless. I have this tier because I can't remember everything. So there's LangGraph, Crew AI, Pydantic AI, Google Agent Development Kit, so ADK, OpenAI ADK, AWS Trends Agents, Llama Index, Microsoft Agents, and that's not even the whole list. It goes on and on and on. So make sure you check out the documentation that is linked in the show notes wherever they appear, and then also check out the Devtoberfest session with my colleague Karim, who also linked a GitHub repository where he shows how you can build your own AI agents with Generative AI Hub, LiteLLM, and Crew AI. And yeah, happy coding over the holidays. Happy holidays and happy coding.
The team behind the Terraform provider for SAP BTP has an early holiday season present for us. A new version, 1.18, has just landed, bringing fixes, improvements, and new features. Here are just three of the highlights. So first, resources and data sources for destinations are now available. MTLS authentication for service brokers is now supported, and there are also some new functions for extracting information from environment instance labels. If you know, you know. Check out the full release details for these and more features. By the way, there's already a patch version, 1.18.1, which you should use. Links in the description.
This month, we see a great new CAP add-in in the form of the SAP Enterprise Analytics add-in. This cool new little feature brings to CAP the support for INA services, or information access. These are particularly useful when you want to consume a service from the SAP Analytics Cloud, particularly if you have a calculation view. It's very easy to use. Drop in the NPM module, and then simply add some annotations to your data model. It's that simple to now add INA services. So if you're interested in that functionality, be sure to check it out today.
A few weeks back, we had a news item on access being temporarily restricted for SAP BTP Cloud Foundry runtimes in the trial environment. Just a few days ago, the SAP BTP trial product team announced that these restrictions have been lifted again, and Cloud Foundry runtimes are now fully available again in trial. That's great news, and another early holiday season present for us. A link to Carolyn's original blog post, which now has an update with these details, is in the description.
I'm so happy to have you here as one of our winners.
I'm Daddy Pregosa. Sergemiske Hana, the happy day possible. All right, yeah. Key takeaway out of that time.
So I really like that I did not have a lot of tech background, but I was able to do the exercises and MPK. So it was really intuitive and everything was really well developed. So I didn't need to have a lot of background knowledge because one cannot know everything about MM. So it was really well made.
That sounds really was great. And now you are Shia and Berlin. One tech ADHD. So what did you like most or what were you looking for to get out of him?
So I just got a little interested in SAP Build and I found out all the SAP Build hands-on workshops here. And that really helped me. So I do not have a prior experience on that, but I started from scratch here, working on the SAP Build and I was actually able to learn a lot. And now I have a certification here on SAP Build Excel.
Yeah, so I have excited about that. Very impressive. Thank you so much.
Thank you.